Please, don't. I'm begging you. Please. She's only a cartoon, okay? She's only a cartoon!
Let's have a discussion, shall we? Animation over the course of history has come a long, long, long way. And I mainly say that because back then, cartoons used to be in black and white. And if those people who have created cartoons saw what was being created today, I think it's safe to say that they would burn every project that they have ever created to the fucking ground. We have one thing to blame this on. Children. Now, I was a child at one point. Children are the driving force for animation, because they're the ones who want to watch it. The bright colors, the smooth movements of the characters, of the crazy characters that are in these animations, and they only get crazier. And from a creative aspect, 2D and 3D animation within the confines of a 2D and 3D world can do amazing things with imagination. Imagination and 2D and 3D animation. Fuck me! These are a lot of big words. All I'm saying is live action movies and books and all of these things, words, live action concepts can do nothing compared to 2D and 3D animation. It simplifies the imagination of the creator to the audience. So, with all of these creative minds coming together to create these amazing animations, why the fuck is the first thing you come up with a child getting fucked? Today we're gonna be talking about Lolis, which, in my opinion, is the most ridiculous fucking thing to ever be comprised by mankind. To all of you living under a rock, you probably don't know what a loli is. A young girl. That's it. The literal definition is just a fucking child.
In Japanese popular culture, lolicon is a genre of fictional media in which young girl characters appear in romantic or sexual contents. The term of portmanteau of English words, lolita and complex, also refers to desire and affection for such characters.
Did you catch that? Did you catch any of that? If you didn't, you need to get your fucking eyes checked. We're going to do a deep analysis on one sentence.
They're just cartoon characters. They're not real.
You won't be in a second. Now, they say this sentence as an excuse to continue jerking the hog to said animations. I'm really fucking uncomfortable saying that sentence. Now, said animations aren't illegal. They're on the internet. Like, if you literally searched up lollipop, you'd easily be able to find it. But I'm here to tell you that that's just a little fucking weird. A little. It's a more than a little, but fuck. You know, I could make this video so much fucking shorter, and I could just simplify this. I could ruin these little fucking creeps right fucking now, but I want to ease into it. We'll go through three sections: context, consistency, and conclusion. The three C's. Context. By context, I mean the context of the situation, the context of what the fuck you're watching, and also the context of you watching the damn thing. Let's start off simple. The difference in culture, Japan and America. But that, fuck, if you guys haven't really rubbed two brain cells together, that's where I'm from. In America, the laws when it comes to the age of consent, etc., are a lot more strict than it would be in other parts of the world. We prefer around 16 to 18. And I know in some other places it ranges from like 14 to 15 or some crazy shit in other parts of the world. But to put it simply, the younger you go, the less of an understanding of a situation you have. So the bigger the age gap, the less of an understanding one individual have than another. So what does this mean? In sexual context, depending on their age, one person is not gonna fucking know what the fuck is going on, and the other is gonna be, yeah, give me all that coochie, ma. But what does this have to do with these animations? It displays that kind of interaction between two people of very different age groups in a specific provocative situation. Sometimes it's really, really fucking bad. Now, you can't necessarily put a label on how creepy something is. You can't use words. So, you know what? I'm gonna use emotions. There are three levels of fucked up creepiness. There's, ooh. And then there's, ah. And then there's, wah! And depending how you react to said thing or depending on how you feel will help you determine how creepy something can be. Let's start off with the least creepy segment, the oopsie daisy, I fucked up segment. This is where someone doesn't even fucking know what these animations are, they don't know the context, they don't know what the heck it is, they just popped onto one of these websites to try it out, and oh no. Shut up. What I mean by that is someone who doesn't know what anime is, who doesn't know what, who hasn't even had any... Who doesn't even know what, hentai is, or any of this crap. They just popped onto it because they were curious, they let one off, and then they read what Loli is, they search it up, and then they realize, oh my god! No! Whoa! See, that's level one. That's where you just... Oh, God. That's where you just stumble upon it and it just happens. You don't do your research. You're just a lazy, clumsy motherfucker. And you just stumble upon it and then... Whoops. And that's probably like a 1 in a million fucking chance. Because majority of people, like, know what anime is. Know what this definition is. And then they look at it. And they're just repulsed. That should be the normal reaction. But then you get to the other two levels of creepy where it's, oh, you did not just do that. I'm talking about the people who willingly go into it knowing that it's a fucking child and imagining themselves in that situation, letting one off to it. No! No, get help! Now! Fucking right now! That's level two. That's where you know it's bad. And you either need to get yourself out of that situation with that person, or you, the person yourself, needs to get help. But then you get to level three. We don't talk about level three on this channel. But you get it, it's messed up. Now let's talk about consistency. By consistency, I mean... when they were introduced to it, and why the fuck are they still watching it? There's really only two situations to this. In situation one, they were young, they were under the age of consent, and they were introduced to it, and then over the course of years, when they grow older than 18, they are still continuing to watch it because when they were younger, they had a grasp on it. It's weird for me to say this, but it's kind of like being adjusted to a certain routine, instead the routine being something very fucking weird. But then you get situation two. And in situation two, it is an adult who is attracted to children continuing to watch it for that sole reason. But then there's like a small, teeny weeny little bit situation three, and there's not even consistency. It kind of intertwines with context, where the guy just stumble upon it, doesn't know what it is, and then all of a sudden they figure out what it is, and then they're like, aah! In conclusion, this is just, in general, fucking weird. There's no other way to say it. There's no other complicated 300% IQ level of way to say it. It is simply just weird. But yeah, that's kind of the psychology behind the people who watch it or stumble upon it. Now let's get to Loli itself. Like I said, they are children. They are animations depicting children. And under the specific word Loli, it is sexual children. Now, back to the age-old question. Why is it bad?
even though I don't fucking know why we're still trying to answer this because it's already been answered, it possibly could confuse young children, and it gives creeps over the age of 18 a scapegoat. Because for those of you who don't know, in America, child is illegal. But why does this technically not go under that category? The only thing separating it is that there's not actual children. It's because they're just cartoons and they're voice acted by adults. Or at least I think they are. If they're not, oh, fuck! But that's actually one of their argument points is, it's just a cartoon and there's not actual children. Yeah, but it depicts children in these situations and you're imagining yourself in these situations. Now here's the question I've been itching to ask you. What if they were real? What if they were real? Would you still do these things to said real child? Would you replicate what you saw in that cartoon upon this now real child? Shit got real fucking dark real quick after I said that. It's because it's not a cartoon anymore, it's a real fucking thing. So is ringing your little jingle bells to this content bad? If you're going to say yes after what we just talked about, you need to seek help. If you're not going to seek help, I can always help you out. Fuck